Let's now start with the first point, the property of angle bisectors of a triangle. In the beginning, to draw the property of angle bisectors of a triangle, we have to first of all draw a triangle. Let us draw an acute angled triangle. So how is the acute angle triangle? An acute angle triangle is a triangle with all its angles less than 90 degrees. Yes, so isn't it? This angle is an acute angle triangle. Yes, all the angles are less than 90 degrees, so this becomes an acute angle triangle. Now we have to draw angle bisectors of the triangle. Okay, angle bisector means we have to see that all the angles are bisected. Bisected means to make two equal parts, two halves of the given angle. How many angles does a triangle have? A triangle has three angles. This is first one, second one, and the third one. Let's draw the angle bisectors. To draw an angle bisector, we want a compass. First, we will mark the arcs for all three. Yes, with the help of same compass we will extend the length between the point, sharp point, and the pencil end, and we will make the angle bisectors. See that you keep the same distance. Do not change the measurement of the compass once it is done, otherwise you will not get the proper measurement. Now we will join the points. Extend it and draw the arrowheads. Fine. Now what do we see? We can see the point of intersection here. Right? We can see the point of intersection here. Now what we have to do, with the help of a set square or with the help of a protractor, we will take protractor, we have to draw a line 90 degree from the center point, intersection point, to all the three sides. This is first side, this is second side, this is the third side. First, let us label it as P, Q and R. You can label it as ABC also, XYZ also, anything, whatever you want. This is just an example. Now we will place this 90 degree line on this point, this 180 degree line on the segment QR, and we will draw a 90 degree line. Yes, so it is somewhere here, right? This line, same way, this line. Okay, So this becomes 90 degree, this becomes 90 degree and this becomes 90 degree. Now, the property of angle bisector of a triangle says that it becomes an inside term. Okay, it becomes an inside term. What means inside term now? Inside term means a triangle whose circle is lying completely inside the triangle. Now, this is a triangle. Yes, this is a triangle where we have drawn angle bisectors for all three angles. Yes, this is one angle bisector, this is another angle bisector, and this is the third angle bisector. Now, it will become an incenter. See how? Let us place the sharp end to the center and we will draw a circle which completely lies inside the given triangle. Okay. See. Yes. So this circle completely lies inside the given triangle. The property of angle bisector of a triangle is satisfied. It is verified. The angle bisector of a triangle are concurrent. Their point of concurrence is called the incenter, and this is shown by the letter I. So we'll label this point as I, this point as A, B, C. You can label it as any other letter also. This is the first property. Second property is the property of perpendicular bisector of the sides of a triangle. For this also, we have to first draw a triangle. Yes, we have to first draw a triangle. Whether it may be acute angled triangle or it can be a right angled triangle or obtuse angled triangle. Let's see what happens. We will draw a obtuse angled triangle. What is told here? The property of perpendicular bisector of a sides of the triangle. Perpendicular bisector means we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of all the three sides of the given triangle. So let's first draw the perpendicular bisector. To draw the perpendicular bisector, you have to first keep in mind that the length, whatever you are adjusting in your compass, it has to be greater than the half of the given length. Now these two are small sides, but this hypotenuse is the longer side, right? This is the third side, side XY. So this adjusted side of a compass should be more than the half of the given segment. So this is more than the half, right? This is more. Now let's draw. This becomes perpendicular bisector for the first side, side ZY. We'll draw for side ZX. Yes. It's somewhere here. Passing from this point. Okay, and the third one, side XY. see the point of intersection is here. Isn't it? We are getting the point of intersection here. Yes. Now what we will do? We can draw a circumcenter. This becomes a radius, and we are able to draw the circle. Okay, I hope you are understanding in center and circumcenter. It's easy to keep in mind, in center means the circle which is drawn inside the given triangle, and circumcenter means the circle which is drawn outside the given triangle. In center is drawn only for the angle bisectors, and circumcenter is drawn for the triangle with perpendicular bisector. The perpendicular bisector of the sides of a triangle are concurrent. Their point of concurrence is called the circumcenter, and it is shown by letter C. So this point becomes C. You can draw an incenter and a circumcenter for all the triangles. It may be acute angle triangle, it may be right angle triangle, or it may be obtuse angled triangle. Thank you.